What separates the good from the legendary in science and engineering? Why do some people spend their careers tinkering at the edges, while others, like the pioneers behind the internet, space travel, or AI, reshape the world? The answer isn't just talent, luck, or hard work. It's something far more radical, a way of thinking. This is the master key hidden inside Richard Hamming's classic, The Art of Doing Science and Engineering. Hamming wasn't just a genius. He was the architect of error-correcting codes, the backbone of modern tech, from your Wi-Fi to Mars rovers. But this book isn't about formulas or coding tricks. It's a manifesto for how to think like the greats. Stick with me, and by the end of this video, you'll walk away with Hamming's battle-tested rules for spotting world-changing problems, turning accidents into breakthroughs, and building a career that matters. Let's dive in. Before we unpack his ideas, let's meet the myth. Richard Hamming worked at Bell Labs in the 1940s and 50s, the Hollywood of innovation, where teams invented the transistor, the laser, and information theory. Imagine working in a building where, at any moment, someone might stroll in and say, "Hey, I just solved the secret to global communication." But Hamming noticed something strange. Surrounded by Nobel Prize winners, he saw colleagues with equal talent but unequal impact. Some became household names, others faded into footnotes. Why? The answer, he realized, wasn't just what they knew, but how they thought. He once said, "The purpose of computing is insight, not numbers." And that's the core of this book. It's not a textbook. It's a mental gym, a training ground for the habits, questions, and obsessions that let ordinary people do extraordinary work. But here's the catch. Hamming doesn't coddle you. This book is a mirror. It'll confront you with questions like, are you working on what truly matters, or just what's easy? And trust me, by the end you'll squirm. But that's how growth works. Rule 1. The courage to work on the right problem. Let's start with the big one. Hamming's first law. If you don't work on important problems, you'll never do important work. Sounds obvious, right? But here's the twist. Most scientists and engineers don't do this. They chase safe, incremental questions, papers that'll get published, projects that'll please a boss. Why? Because important problems are terrifying. They're messy, ill-defined, and might take decades. Hamming tells the story of Claude Shannon, the father of information theory. While others focused on improving phone lines, Shannon asked, asterisk, what is information, really? How can we measure it? That question birthed the digital age. So how do you find your Shannon problem? Hamming's advice. Look for failure points. What's holding your field back? What do experts dismiss as too hard or impossible? For Hamming, it was noisy communication channels. Everyone accepted garbled messages as inevitable until he invented error-correcting codes. Ask yourself, if I vanish tomorrow, would anyone notice? If not, you're playing small. Hamming's challenge? Write down 3 problems that could redefine your field. Then, work on them. Even if you fail, you'll fail forward. Rule 2. Prepare for serendipity. Now here's where Hamming gets counterintuitive. You can't plan breakthroughs, but you can prepare for them. He shares a wild story. One weekend, he was fixing a glitch in an early computer. Instead of cursing the broken machine, he asked, "What can this error teach me?" That mistake led to Hamming codes, now embedded in every CD, satellite, and smartphone. But here's the key. Luck didn't hand him the answer. His mind was primed to see it. Like a sculptor staring at a block of marble, he saw the hidden shape inside the chaos. Hamming's mantra, luck favors the prepared mind. He borrowed that from Pasteur. But hey, good artists steal. How do you prepare? 1. Master the fundamentals. You can't connect dots you haven't learned. 2. Keep a serendipity journal. When something surprises you, a weird result, a customer complaint, ask, what's this trying to teach me? 3. Talk to outsiders. Hamming hung out with physicists, linguists, even psychologists. Why? The best ideas come from the adjacent possible. Think of it like mental stretching. The more flexible your brain, the more luck you can catch. Rule 3. Creativity is a discipline. Repeat after me. Genius is not a gift. It's a habit. Hamming hated the myth of the lone genius, struck by inspiration. Real creativity, he argued, is a grind, a daily practice. His routine? Ruthless. Morning deep think hours. No emails, no meetings, just you, a notebook, and the problem. Weekly self-interrogation. Asterisk. Did I work on something important this week? Or did I hide in busy work? Study the greats. Not just their discoveries, but how they thought. Einstein's love of thought experiments. Marie Curie's obsession with measurement. But here's my favorite Hamming hack. The 10% exploration rule. Spend 10% of your time learning wildly outside your field. If you're a programmer, study botany. If you're an engineer, read poetry. Why? Breakthroughs happen at the intersection of disciplines. Hamming put it bluntly, the more you know, the more you can know. It's compound interest for your brain. All right, time for some hard truths. Hamming doesn't let you off the hook. He's the drill sergeant of innovation. First, you are your own worst enemy. Excuses like, I don't have time, or I need more resources, are just masks for fear. Hamming saw it at Bell Labs. Two engineers with the same skills. One changed the world. The other complained about office lighting. Second, knowledge is not wisdom. You can memorize every equation in your field and still be mediocre. Wisdom is judgment, knowing which problems to pick, when to pivot, and how to see patterns. Third, the 80-20th rule of greatness. 80% of your impact comes from 20% of your work. So why are you wasting time on the other 80%? Cut the fluff. Say no. Obsess over leverage. And finally, the ultimate question. Do you want to do safe, forgettable work or something that outlives you? Hamming's answer? It's your choice. But choose wisely. You're trading your life for it. Asterisk. Now you might think, asterisk, this book was written in the 90s. What does a dead mathematician know about AI, CRISPR, or quantum computing? But that's the magic. Hamming's principles are timeless. Let's translate them. 1. For coders, don't just chase the latest framework. Ask, what's the human problem here? How can I simplify complexity? 2. For leaders, replace hustle culture with think culture. Give your team Hamming's morning hours, protected time to go deep. 3. For students, stop chasing grades. Hamming. You're judged by what you finish, not what you start. Build something real. 4. For everyone, start a Hamming hour. Once a week, ask, did I do work that mattered, or did I just stay busy? And here's a challenge. Pick one small problem you're working on. Now multiply its stakes by 10. What would it look like if it truly changed things? That's your new goal. So here's the truth. The difference between good and great isn't genetics. It's not even hard work. It's working with intention. Hamming's book is a wake-up call, a reminder that we're all trading days of our lives for work, so why not make it matter? If you take one thing from this video, let it be this. You don't need permission to do great work. Hamming didn't wait for a manager's approval to invent his codes. Shannon didn't ask if he was, quote, allowed to rethink information. They saw a crack in the world and pried it open. So, what's your crack? What problem keeps you up at night? Drop it in the comments. Let's make this a hub for people who want to build legacies, not resumes. And if you want more breakdowns of game-changing books, hit subscribe. I'll be here, every week, handing you tools to think bigger. Until then, go find your important problem. And don't just solve it, redefine it. Thanks for watching.